Welcome back to Book Banter, presented by the Public Library of Youngstown and Mahoning County. My name is Alex, and joining me today is my friend and fellow librarian, Amy.
Hi.
And we are going to be discussing The Bells by Dhonielle Clayton.
So The Bells is about our main character, Camille, who is a bell. And what a bell is basically in this world, the population is kind of subhuman. They have gray skin, they have red eyes, and it doesn't do well for their mental abilities either. And so what the bells do is they have magical powers, and they are able to transform people to look any way they want. And so there's this kind of abuse of power because, you know, you could want to have purple hair one day and blue hair the next. And our main character is one of the few bells, and she is competing to be the favorite, which is the bell who gets to help the queen and the royal family and suitors. So she is competing against her sisters, but there is kind of a dastardly plot underneath all that beauty. So Alex and I both read this book. We have to do our thumbs up or our thumbs down. Alex, are you ready?
I am.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we both liked it. So Alex, what did you like about The Bells?
Oh gosh, there were so many things I liked about it. I thought that it was just very, very interesting. Like, I don't think I've read anything in like the YA fantasy realm that's like been very similar to this. I really liked Dhonielle Clayton's world building was fantastic. It was like so enchanting, and it was like lush, and her descriptions were super stunning. And you were able to like, even though like it kind of, the story moved really slow at the beginning, but even with it moving so slow, it still was a page turner for me. I just thought she did a really, really good job at like building the world and making you be able to like imagine, you know, this flowery realm, you know, kind of that, you know, at least how I kind of pictured it. So
definitely I imagined it very colorful. Yeah. And her descriptions, you know, we see the entire book through Camille's point of view, and just the way she describes different locations, but also like her ability and her gift of transforming people. It was so descriptive and just stunning how painful it sounded, but also, you know, her way of doing like kind of social commentary of, you know, what is beautiful. And, you know, I found that really interesting.
Yeah. So it kind of played off of like society's obsession with like your outward appearance, right? At least that's kind of like the theme that I kind of took from it. What are expectations of beauty and how they could, you know, be crippling or stifling to, you know, especially young women. And then I also really liked, I thought the characters were really well developed, at least like the main character. Some of the side characters I wish we would have got a little bit more from, but it is a trilogy. So I think that maybe we might get a little bit more of the backstory from some of the other bells that kind of fell off at the beginning. But I really liked Camille, Remy, and Adele. And I can't wait to see like more from them. And what else? Oh, and I really, really, the villains are kind of like what's like their development and like their storyline kind of is what like stole the show for me, just because they were like super, it was super dark and like they were so cruel, and they were definitely like the perfect antagonist, I thought, for like creating like the complex and difficult decisions that Camille kind of faces throughout the book.
Definitely. Like there's a couple of like twists and turns, so I don't want to give anything too much away, but yeah, our villains of the story were very dastardly, and their kind of just their psychoanalysis is kind of concerning for one particular
character. It was pretty sinister at times. So
for sure.
Yeah. Yes. I'm trying to think. Oh, so it takes place in Orleans, which is kind of like a alternate New Orleans, you know, and I definitely got the vibe. Like, it felt like very French Quarter to me. If that's like kind of how I pictured it. But I just thought it was like so interesting, like the magic that they use and kind of like the, it's so hard to talk about without giving too much away, like some of those, like the plot points, but I'm trying to think of some things that happen because of, you know, wanting to be beautiful, but it's not going to make sense if I speak it out loud. So I'm just going to stop with my words.
I like that there is like a mystery surrounding it though. Mm-hmm. Like, we don't really know how the bells came to be. We don't know how important their magic is. And we hear about these different generations of bells, but Camille kind of learns pretty early on in the story that what she has been told growing up might not necessarily be true.
Right.
And so that's kind of always in the back of her mind and us as the readers, kind of like, okay, wait, this just happened. This doesn't make sense with what we have been told as a plot point. What does this mean? How is this going to be incorporated? And definitely, I think like learning about just the bells, you know, how they came to be, what the extent of their power is super interesting. Mm-hmm. And kind of like how our villains want to use the bells to do their bidding, I thought was really well done.
I mean, I thought it was exceptional. It, from start to finish, I couldn't put it down.
I was just going to say, I listened to this.
Yeah.
And it was fantastic. The audiobook was amazing. The reader did such a good job. And to go back to what you said about like the little French like twist, like she read some of the characters with it, like a French accent.
Yeah.
It was really like helped picture certain things, as well as like, I also listened to this book, which was, I don't know, over 11 hours long in 2 days. So I did not want to put it down. I was just doing everything throughout my day and like listening to this story.
Yeah.
I was so compelled by Camille and, like you mentioned, some of the side characters like Remy, mm-hmm. and August, and just like all those characters, how they were all going to fit, you know, especially like with her sisters. So I felt for them and I wanted to keep reading because I wanted to see what was going to happen.
Yeah, I definitely can't wait to jump into the next two. And I'm, now that you said that, I'm going to get the second one. I'm going to listen to it because it seems like the narration was amazing. So I'm going to try it that way.
You should.
Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to discuss before we close out?
I think this is Dhonielle Clayton's first book, and I just thought it was exceptional. Mm-hmm. I thought she did such a good job writing a very interesting fantasy, but it's also a dystopian.
Yeah.
And so we get that like political intrigue of like what's going on with the royals, how is the different like caste systems, you know, developed, and what does this mean for the characters who may not be wealthy? And I thought it was so intriguing, and it leaves on such a cliffhanger that I already jumped into the second one. So I feel like Dhonielle Clayton just like reeled me in, and yeah. I was happy to, you know, take the bait.
Yeah.
So I really, really enjoyed this story and her storytelling.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I definitely think that it's going to be one that especially teens will gravitate towards. And I think that anyone who picks it up will like it. If they enjoy like that fantasy dystopian genre.
Definitely.
Okay, well, safe to say that Amy and I both loved The Bells by Dhonielle Clayton. You can put it on hold and pick it up at your local public library of Youngstown Mahoning County branch, or check it out on Hoopla as a digital ebook and digital audiobook, and also in Libby or Overdrive as a digital audiobook. And we hope you enjoyed this episode of Book Banter, and we look forward to seeing you next time. Bye, everyone.
Bye.